I could tell you, I don't think a lot, I think a lot of people are up now. They're all hashtag I am up. Of course, come and check it out here. Starts on Saturday. I'm kicking these shoes off, but I may keep the pantyhose on. It does feel kind of good, well, actually. Right, I'm not going to pee in them, I promise. I'll send it back to the studio.
I'd like to introduce you all to Marjorie Taylor Greene's boyfriend, who you just saw in that video, who is Brian Glenn of Right Side Broadcasting Network, which is one of those, you know, fake conservative news networks. So that video was him, depicted him in dressed as a woman. And we don't know exactly when the video is from, but he was an anchor for WFAA-TV, which is an ABC affiliated media company in Dallas from 2013 to 2015. So honestly, not that long ago. But of course, Marjorie Taylor Greene is a very good handmaiden. So because of that, she is standing by her man. Sorry. Mm-hmm. I've got two big dogs who are also excited about this story. But let's pull up this tweet from Marjorie Taylor Greene. She says, "I'm literally LOLing," which is something people only say when they're the maddest they've ever been in their entire lives. at Brian Glenn TV, dressed in drag for morning news in Dallas years ago, reporting on an upcoming local theater production, and the morons over at Patriot Takes think this is an attack. Brian loves the throwback and is reposting. The left is so stupid. But Marjorie Taylor Greene, there's a reason that people are bringing this up. And it's probably because you're so stupid and all of the things that you've had to say about drag. So let's pull up a few of those things that you've said. First one, I'm introducing a bill to make it illegal for children to be exposed to drag queen performances. So Taylor Greene, you better keep your kids away from your new boyfriend, apparently. And then we have this next one that says, and reading this gave me, you know, maybe a stroke or something, trying to get through the litany of nonsense she tweeted here. If you are defending pedophile priests and those who protect them, groomer teachers and Disney LGBTQ propaganda, drag queen story time saying it's not Satan convincing women to abort their unplanned child and that children can be manipulated to change their gender, you're wrong. The fact that people think this woman is smart. This woman is an elected official. She gets to vote on what laws we have in this country. But okay, last one from Marjorie Taylor Greene. Protecting your children from drag queen child predators is not a hate crime. It's being a good parent. Well, I hope then that you're a good parent and keep your your new boyfriend away from your kids. But I mean, ultimately, pointing out Republican hypocrisy, I think it's not very effective at changing the minds of Republicans. But I just want to remind the viewers how ridiculous and hypocritical these people are, because it's fine when her new boyfriend dressed up in drag, right? That's cool. But if you are a member of the LGBTQ community and you do it, then you're a pedophile. Her boyfriend, not a pedophile. If you're gay, pedophile. It's just, it's ridiculous.
No, absolutely. And if this were Chuck Schumer, first of all, I'd really want to see that. And I think that'd be hilarious. But two, they would absolutely say, look, Chuck Schumer is a pedophile. He's dressed in drag. This is not funny. You know, like the gender ideology is infecting our da da da. And it's like, no, man. And like, actually, the fact that, you know, this uggo dude decided to make himself, you know, put on pantyhose, Brian Glenn, and sort of debase all drag, let's be real, because he's not pulling it off. Is his freedom, it's fine. Like, it is totally fine, 100% fine. And ultimately, it was a joke, right? And that's, I think, like, it is performative. And that's sort of what drag queens, you know, and of course, you know, RuPaul says all the time, like, you know, you're born naked and everything else is drag. Gender is a performative thing. And so that's why, and I think this is like, there are overtones of misogyny to the ways that like some men, especially like, you know, cis straight dudes will dress in drag as like, duh, isn't it, women are stupid. You know what I mean? A la this, a la Steven Crowder, right? But it is a performance, right? He's doing that for the lulz because it's funny, or he thinks it's funny. And then, you know, just finally, I have to say this. I think every man should dress in a dress at some point in their lives, just wear a skirt. Wear a skirt, wear a dress, do a Homer Simpson moo-moo situation. It's freeing and we all know you wanna do it. And look, women can wear pants. I love pants. I don't know what I would do if I had to wear a dress, but vice versa. Sometimes you wanna just be a like airy, fluffy little princess. Everyone should be able to be an airy, fluffy little princess.
Absolutely, I totally agree. I think a lot of men have no idea what they're missing out on. It can be very freeing. And like you said, women can wear pants. So men, come on, just pick up a skirt at the store. You don't even have to leave the house. Just try it on, see how you feel.
No, that's exactly. Everyone starts off sort of going in the dressing room. I mean, come on, like me, 15 years old, trying on like floofy dresses in Bloomingdale's. That's all, am I gonna buy it? Of course not, you know? But that's what you do. You go to the dressing room, you try on the floofy dress and you feel better, all right? You get out your yayas, your gender yayas, all right?
I'll say, because you mentioned Steven Crowder, he, you know, is putting on a performance when he dresses in drag, but he's also, you know, putting on a performance in gender every time he straps himself into his gun bra.
Yes. Okay,
because that is, you are performing as a male.
The most performative, yeah. Mm-hmm.
For more political news breakdowns, interviews, stories of activism, and me trying my hardest to care about the occasional big celebrity news story, subscribe to our YouTube channel at youtube.com/thedamagereport. And you can ring the bell wherever it is so you don't miss anything.